Hi, today I'm going to show you how to use our Voltstick sound. Voltstick are the original inventors of the non-contact voltage detector and were the first to bring it to the market nearly 40 years ago. The sound is very close to the original Voltstick, but the sound in the part number means this one has an audible indication as well as visual. Okay, I'm just going to show you what a few of the markings on the Voltstick sound refer to. CE and IEC markings mean that this Voltstick meets all the relevant electrical safety and environmental standards. The UL means that this Voltstick also meets the US standard and carries UL approval. Cat 3, 1000 volts AC. This means that this Voltstick has an overvoltage safety rating of 1000 volts in a Cat 3 zone. All of our Voltsticks in the range have a shirt clip and they're all kept to a handy size, and this makes the Voltstick sound an ideal tool for an electrician to keep with them at all times so that they can check for voltages in cables, sockets, junction boxes, fuse boards and so on. If it's not already in your pocket, being bright green is going to make it very easy to find. Okay then, so how to use the Voltstick sound. The most important safety feature of all the Voltsticks in our range is that there's no on-off switch. So the Voltstick's always ready to use and you won't forget to switch it on. It's very important to confirm that your Voltstick is working correctly before you start. And the best way to do this is to check the Voltstick against a known live source in the area that you're about to work. So this might be a socket, it might be a switch, or it could be the flex to an electrical appliance. Here's what to do. Hold the Voltstick behind the safety guard. Firstly, I'll show you how to test if your Voltstick's working correctly using an electrical socket outlet. The Voltstick sound is designed with a sensitivity that will make it possible to show you the live and the neutral. Here you'll see the Voltstick lights up red and beeps to show you the presence of a voltage. And you can double check this by just switching the socket on and off. So now we know the Voltstick's working. A quick tip about the tip. The Voltstick will become slightly more sensitive if it's used at an angle rather than end on. So if at first the Voltstick doesn't indicate, try using it side on. If the Voltstick illuminates, it doesn't make a sound, this can be a sign that the batteries are weak. Follow the instructions and replace the batteries immediately. We can check if the Voltstick's working correctly on a light switch. Switch the light on, move the stick around the switch until it illuminates and beeps. Then if you turn the light off, the Voltstick should go off. Okay, so now you know your Voltstick's working. There's another way you can check it, is against a flex of an electrical appliance. So remember, the sound is designed to detect 230 volts from around 4 millimeters. So always check the whole circumference of the flex. You'll see and hear the Voltstick go on and off as the live moves further and closer to the Voltstick. So again here, we can see the Voltstick's working correctly. Now that you've confirmed your Voltstick's working, you can repeat this procedure on what you need to test. And remember, when you finish testing, double check the Voltstick was working correctly on that known live source again. If at any stage you don't get the result you're expecting from your Voltstick, make sure the batteries are working and replace them if necessary. And it's always a good practice to remove the batteries if the Voltstick's not going to be used for some time. There are also further explanations of other external factors that can affect the results from a Voltstick in our How to Use a Voltstick blog. And you'll find more information on this and the whole Voltstick range by visiting our website at www.voltstick.com.